I think smart contracts as a definition has actually gone through some kind of changes or small evolution. Initially, I think it was actually a conception of a digital agreement that was tamper-proof and could know things about the world, right? So it could get proof and it could define that something happened and it could conclude an outcome and release payment or do something else. That's actually the definition of smart contracts that I began working in this industry with 7 or 8 years ago when I started making smart contracts. That is the conception that I had of a smart contract. Then what happened was that was really hard to do, right? Building that type of tamper-proof digital agreement that could also know things about the real world and release payments back to people about those events that were codified in this tamper-proof format was actually a very tall order. Turns out it's consistent of three parts. It's consisting of the contract, the proof about what happened, and, you know, the release of value. The way things have evolved so far is that the definition has now come to mean on-chain code, right? So it's come to mean the codification of contractual agreement on a blockchain, right? So there's some code somewhere on some blockchain that defines what the agreement is. Now, that eliminates the part of the definition that's related to knowing things about the world, and it partly eliminates the definition about payments and stuff like that. But basically, it's on-chain code, right? We, in our recent work on a second white paper, have actually put out a different definition that we call hybrid smart contracts that actually tries to go back to the initial definition that I started with 7 or 8 years ago, which basically says that there's some proof somewhere that's proven to the contract, and the contract can know that, and the contract can gain proof. Then it can use that proof to settle the agreement that's codified on a blockchain. So you both need a mechanism to provide proof. You need a mechanism to codify the contract in a tamper-proof way on something like a blockchain. And then, as with all contracts, there's a presumption that there's some kind of release of value.